exothermic or endothermic. In exothermic reactions and processes, heat energy is given out. In endothermic reactions and processes, heat energy is taken in. Using exothermic reactions. Some exothermic reactions are used to produce self-heating cans of food or drink. For example, a can of self-heating coffee or self-heating food contains two chemicals, which are in separate compartments. When you press a button, the two chemicals mix with each other and react. The reaction warms up the food or drink. The chemicals used are calcium oxide and water. When the water and calcium oxide are mixed together, they react, and heat is given off. Calcium oxide plus water, rightward arrow, calcium hydroxide. This is an expensive idea because of the difficulty of making the compartments in the tin, so that the food or drink is not contaminated. People sometimes use ice packs when they injure themselves. These packs are stored in a fridge or freezer until they are needed. When the ice pack is placed on the injured area, the melting ice takes in heat from the injured area. This is an endothermic process. It means that the injured area is cooled and this often prevents it from swelling up. After use, the ice pack can be placed back in the freezer and used again. Some ice packs are made using substances that undergo an endothermic process when they mix together. These packs can be used even when you don't have a refrigerator or freezer. The pack has two compartments inside, each containing a different substance. These substances are usually ammonium nitrate and water. When you push on the pack and break the compartment containing ammonium nitrate, the water mixes with it and the ammonium nitrate begins to dissolve. This is an endothermic process, so the temperature drops. A chemical ice pack being used to treat an injury. Exothermic and endothermic reactions can be identified by taking the temperature at the start and the end of the reaction. Exothermic and endothermic reactions and processes can be used to produce useful items.